नमो तस्से भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा सम्बुद्धस्स। नमो तस्से भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा सम्बुद्धस्स। नमो तस्से भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा सम्बुद्धस्स। We continue with the Citta Vithi chapter today. So, do you have any questions from last week's class before we continue? Anything that you want to bring up before we continue? Okay. Then, the great object. Page number 159. The object is called great when it enters the avenue of sense after having passed a few moments, and it's unable to survive till the arising of the registration mind moments. In that case, at the end of the javanas, there is subsidence into life continuum and no arising of registration consciousness. And no arising of registration consciousness. That is when it is not, if the tadalambana does not arise, then what happens? What happens then is after the javana, it automatically goes into the subsidizes into the bhavanga, right? But that also denotes a weaker object. That also denotes a weaker object. Guide to verse 7. The object is called great, etc. In this kind of cognitive process, after the object has arisen, two or three Atita Bhavanga Chittas pass before its impact causes the Bhavanga to vibrate. Since the object and sense door can only endure for 17 mind moments, this process does not give any scope for the registration chittas to arise. Registration cannot occur even when there are two Atita Bhavangas, since registration occurs either for two mind moments or not at all. For registration occurs for two mind moments or not at all. When there are two Atita Bhavanga Chittas, Shiroma, yes? Okay. When there are two Atita Bhavanga Chittas, 15 more Chittas can arise during this lifespan of the object. In such a case, both the object and the sense door perish simultaneously with the dissolution moment of the first Bhavanga Chitta. Following the Javana phase, following the first Bhavanga Chitta, following the Javana phase. When there are three Atita Bhavangas, scope remains for 14 more Chittas to arise. And in this case, the sense object and sense door perish simultaneously with the last Javana Chitta. This kind of cognitive process is also called a javanavara, a course ending with javana. Now, before we discussed, we started on the chapter of Citta Vithi, and following the first enumeration into the six sixes that we will be going through, right? We come to now see the six processes, the six types of Citta Vithi that arise. These six types of Citta Vithi arises at the six cognitive processes, the eye-do process, the ear-do, nose-do. As such, we have already gone through these. At these respective doors, these cognitive processes, the eye cognitive process, as such, arises. Now, what we are discussing today is when those cognitive processes takes object, right? Takes object, they fall under the sixfold presentation of objects. Right? When an object falls into a chittaviti, that chittaviti receives this object as very great, great, slight, very slight, clear and obscure when it comes to the mind. Ekyanya ati mahantaramana, mahantaramana, parittaramana, ati parittaramana, chati panchadvare, manodvare, vibhuta, avibhuta, ramana. Hari, vibhuta, avibhuta, ramana in the manodvara. Now, when it comes to the panchadvara, what does that mean? That means when we take objects through the five sense doors, there you have atimahanta objects, mahanta objects, paritta objects, atiparitta objects. This variation occurs due to a number of reasons according to conditionality, hetupala, because we know that for one specific condition, there can be multiple causes, isn't it? Hence, it can be for different reasons, but the main reason, let us say, if there is interest upon the object, great interest upon the object, then the likelihood of atimahantaramana arising, type of object arising, is quite high. Right? Because you're looking for that object. It is something that you want at that moment. Right? Now, during such an occasion, when it comes to Atimahanta Ramana Chitta Viti, all right, are we clear, everyone, up to that?
Yeah.
When it comes to Atimahanta Ramana Chitta Viti, now, where is the Chitta Viti? Ah, there you go. Now, this is Atimahanta Ramana Chitta Viti. Right? How do we know that this is the Atimahantaramana Chitta Viti? In an Atimahantaramana Chitta Viti, you see the Bhavanga vibrates, right? The past Bhavanga, the vibrational, the arresting. See? You have, on the other side, you have seven Javanas and two Tadalambanas. And two tadalambanas. For the object to arise quickly upon impingement, which is denoted by this, you see here, right? Which is denoted by atita bhavanga, bhavanga chalana, bhavanga upacheda. Ekiyanne, through the duration of one mind moment, right, one mind moment, it has matured, the object has matured where the arresting bhavanga occurs. When the object matures, the mind has to take that object, right?
Does that happen in all objects or only
in all
atimahara?
In
all
everything, in everything,
okay,
right? In everything, if it is atimahantaramana, right? Meaning a very great object, there, how depending upon what is this object great? Depending on our focus and attention, this object is great, right? If there is no interest whatsoever for this particular, let us say there's a piece of paper on your table and you know, something that you are not looking for, it's there, you have no interest in it. You might see it many times, but no sanya arises out of that piece of paper being on your table. Why? Because there is no interest in it, for it, nothing pushing you to inquire about it. As such, when there is liking towards the object becomes atimahantarammana. Right? So, for example, if you would take a somanas object where there is great liking, the likelihood of that object being atimahantarammana is high. How do you know that an object is atimahantarammana? Because it arrests the bhavanga promptly upon arising. And what happens, you see? The object survives upon to registration. On to registration. When it comes to, let us say, mahantarammana, parittarammana, atiparittarammana, right? Now, this is what we are talking about, which seems so confusing. This chart makes it all the more easy, right? Now, what we are reading is, they've explained to us in their way, this process right here. You see, everyone, right? And then what it is saying is, it's telling you about this moment here, right? Now, this moment here, I'm right, right? This moment here, bhavanga, past bhavanga, vibrational bhavanga, arresting bhavanga. And then the F denotes the five sense door process. Now see, in the very next one, what do you see? You see, the arresting bhavanga is prolonged by one mind moment. That is what you see, isn't it? Right? When it comes to the great object, the second part of the great object, you see the arresting bhavanga prolonged by yet another one mind moment. When you go down in such a way, you see that every moment, or the moment it becomes weaker and weaker. How does it get weaker? Because the object is weak, the time that it takes to impinge upon the mind is longer.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because the object is weak. The penny doesn't drop. Right? Because you're not maybe looking for it, or there might not be interest in it, or maybe there's restlessness in the mind. Maybe the mind is not focused. Maybe the mind is all over the place. For different reasons, this object might be not getting your attention. Right now, the object that you're taking might be a very great object, or it could go into the obscure levels, depending on that attention there. Right? Hence the power of object. Hence the power of object. Okay. Any question?
Pante, can I ask you, what do you mean by the power of the object, please?
When we remember something, when we hold a certain thing in mind, this visual, this image, this prajnapti that you build is a direct result, or let us say a result causative upon the experiences at the five sense doors, right? Now, with or in accordance with the way that the mind decides to, let us say, see, yonso mansikara or ayonso mansikara, depending on how much interest you, there might be yonso mansikara. Your mind might be in a stage of yonsomanasikara. However, what if the mind is not very energetic? No. Now, yes, you're in a state of yonsomanasikara, but the mind is not energetic. So then what happens? If the mind is not energetic, the objects that are perceived, just because they are yonsomanasikara right with right attention, we cannot say that they are strong objects. Right? That they are strong objects. Why can't we say that they are strong objects? Why? Because the object takes longer to arrest the bhavanga, to break the bhavanga, to impinge upon the mind. Does that make sense, Hirante? That is what I mean with the power. So now, later on, if we go further, this power of object, or let us say the object is remembered for a certain thing, for a certain reason. Let us say this reason is steeped in ditti, kiyamu, right? Ditti, view. Right? So the attachment is there, shouldered upon ditti, view. Now this ditti view is formed where? Right? Is formed where? It's formed where the object takes place. Right? Now let us say at an occasion, let us say an occasion which is significant, right? An occasion which is significant. Because of how significant the occasion is, what is, let us say, pronounced in that occasion, during that occasion, strikes far more deeply. Right, strikes far more deeply. Okay, now let us say this occasion might be because of an environment. Right, if you're meditating, let us say, somewhere which is very holy, now this effect of the holy place being in your mind, instilling or being causative in your mind. Different environments, different. Causes, all of these things fall to be then conditions. Nothing far more special than the other, however, determined and manipulated by different other causes and effects. Right? Causes and effects. Let us say.
Desirous objects, Mahantaram, Ati Mahantaram,
Great desire for the objects, yes.
great desire.
Great desire for the objects. Okay? Great desire for the object makes it Ati Mahanta Ramana. Okay? Ati Mahanta Ramana. So let us.
Mahantaram
It
Bante,
was a chutta kadoi. Ready and end.
Yani, Ramana,
Oh. Ati Mahantaramana, Mahantarama, Paritaramana, Etika Okkoma. Now, we will come to read more about it and learn more about it ahead, right? Me, Arinetan. Hari, slight object, great object. Here. The object is so, the mega kiwani, Hari. Deng api apao kiwamu. The object is called great, etc. In this kind of cognitive process, after the object has arisen, two or three atita bhavanga chittas pass before its impact causes the bhavanga to vibrate. Right? So atita bhavanga chalana, bhavanga upacheda. So it first, the before the resting two times, it vibrated. Right? Since the object and sense door can only endure for 17 mind moments, the process must be done within this time frame. This process does not give any scope for the registration chittas to arise, meaning if the object takes longer to arise, then it will not be able to finish its course during that time. Right? That is causative amongst that is causative by the mere na by the mere nature of the object, right? It is by the mere nature of the object. There is nothing more or less to it. The fact that it is great or the fact that it is not so great does not have any, let us say, bearing on how good or bad the object is, or how pleasant or unpleasant the object is. It has no bearing, really, right? However, the pleasantness, the unpleasantness can be a factor, right? Can be a factor for it being a Atimahantaramana, Mahantaramana, Parittaramana, Kuddhakaramana, Atikuddha, all of that. It is, you realize that none of these objects really have any meaning. In reality, we are all mad. You expecting me to say something far more deeper, wasn't it? But really, that is
එතකොට මන්තෙන් even the javanas get lessened if
right.
there are a lot of avanga atita bhavanga going
See,
then the javanas get less as well.
when the javanas, now the last sphere of the javanas, you see at the second part of the great object, right? Not very great, great object. When the javanas, the seven javanas, are unable to arise, what happens? They do not arise at all. Which means, right, the object, for the object to be seen properly from this moment on, the object is not felt properly. Meaning, let me reword it in a better way. After, because of how subtle the object is at this point, the object does not possess enough power to fuel a javana process. Hence, it arises and ceases without a javana arising. Let us see, though, what are the types of mind that are there, if not for the javana. You can see Bhavanga is there. Now starts from the starting of this bracket. It's the 17 mind moments here, right? Within these 17 mind moments, you can see this is the Bhavanga without the object. That is what the B denotes. The Bhavanga without the object, right? The past Bhavanga, the Bhavanga Chalana, the Bhavanga Upacheda, these are words that are used to denote that the Bhavanga, the resting Bhavanga, has been disturbed. Disturbed by what? Disturbed by an object. Arising of an object. All right. Now, at that moment of that arising of object, Atita Bhavanga arises. Atita Bhavanga. Four Atita Bhavangas. Then Bhavanga Chalana Bhavanga Upacheda. Panchadvara Vajana. Chakkhu Vinyana. Sampaticchana. Santirana, Vottapana, Bhavanga, 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 Bhavanga.
So why three Uttapanas?
Why three Vottapanas? Trying to grasp the object, Echaratam assume. Trying to grasp the object. Now the javana process is not running, no? Meaning no such knowing depth, in-depth knowing of object arises at this time. Here, now, whatever that the object is, the only thing that could take that object again and again is only the mind itself. As mind itself As what? Not to know, but to simply try to grasp at that object. For that purpose, manodvaravajana, manodvaravajana, manodvaravajana. And
Then there is identification there. දැන් මේ වගේ හිතක් තෙන්නේ මේ වර්ණ රූප දකින්න කොට දැක්කොත් දැක්ක විතරයි
දැන්
කියලා.
බලන්න මේ
Because javanas don't arise, sankhara doesn't arise, sannya doesn't arise. ඔත්තපනකින් බවංග ගිහිල්ලා. නේ? So the slight object කියන්නේ දැක්කොත් දැක්ක විතරයි කියලා වගේ දෙයක්ද?
අපි එහෙම තේරුම් ගන්න හැදුවොත් if we try to go down that way of looking at this we must also before we do so we must understand objects at the top here they make a lot of changes they cause a lot of changes they are very powerful causes right objects at the bottom here Right? Towards the end of this, it weakens. It weakens. Vipassana is a very powerful form of learning. At that stage, the object cannot be said to be weak, but it is very strong, actually, even more stronger than usual. ඒ කියන්නේ මේ අතිමහන්තාරම්මන from අතිමහන්තාරම්මන to obscure කුද්ධකාරම්මන අතිකුද්ධකාරම්මන this variation or the difference here is upon the weakness. So the lower that you go or the more time it takes to take
Yeah.
the object means that the mind or the object is weak.
Okay.
Right? Now, when we take moments of vipassana, vipassana insight, those kinds of moments are very strong, powerful, ekagrata, sati, moments of mind. Right? During those moments of mind, the mind works actually more acutely. Object ka atharinawa kiyala manasa. The 17 mind moments, within that time, the 17 mind moments run. Here, what is the reason that the object does not occur? Because the object is not properly grasped. It's like, for example, when you're walking across, let us say your home, you won't be noting every single thing. Maybe someone would, right? But a spot on a wall or whatnot, right? But you might very well, these types of objects might be falling into your eye. However, these are not all cognized and known and interpreted. That is what this is talking about.
Okay.
Right? Interpreted. Right? Now, these types of object, mahantaramana, atimahantaramana, parittaramana, atiparittaramana, these arise at the five sense doors.
Bante, itakota the very slight object kyanne ati paritaramane vada. Ewata dehema kyanne the very slight object kyala kyanne ati paritaramana. Ita wada chitta uda tiyene eka paritaramana.
Oh.
Ita wada uda tiyene ewa
mahantaramana
ati mahantaram. Okay, thank you.
Bhante, they make this can vary from person to person for the same object, no? For some person,
what do you mean?
The great object, it becomes great for somebody.
Yeah.
But for somebody, another person, it can be a very slight object.
Yeah. Huh? Yeah. It does not, again, to re-emphasize on the fact that it does not depend on the object. It depends on the mind that views the object.
That's right. Yeah.
Right.
How
so
I thought, yeah.
It can be different to anyone.
බන්ධේ වෙරි ස්ලයිට් ඔබ්ජෙක්ට් කියන එක අර පෙරිෆෙරල් ඒව කියත හැකි එතකොට
කියන්න
පෙරිෆරි එක
පුළුවන්. කියන්න පුළුවන්. කියන්න
වැඩිය
පුළුවන්.
රෙජිස්ටර් වෙන්නේ නැති එකනේ
යා. දැන් කියමු දැන් පාර යනට කවුරු කියනවා බලන්න අර වාහනේ කියලා. එතකොට වාහනේ ගිහිල්ලා ඉවරයි. But you get like the shadow of it or the silhouette of it. Right? එතකොට රෙජිස්ටර් වෙන්නේ නැහැ. But අර අර යම් කිසි අර ස්ලයිඩ් ෆෝම් එකකින් කියන්න පුළුවන් මේක වාහනයක් කියලා. ඒත් ඒ කියන්නේ දැකලා නෙමෙයි හිතලා. ඒ
දැන්
ෆෝම්
මට
එකට.
එක්ස්ම්පල් එකක් ආව මෙහෙම එකක් අපි දැන් ස්ටේෂන් එකකින් එළියට එනවා somebody is coming to meet us to pick us up then our focus is looking for that person the relative and as soon as you see the relative that becomes a very great object that is a person and if all the other people around could be the very slight objects Name.
Absolutely, absolutely. Let us say you go to the airport or somewhere and you see someone that you weren't expecting or never even imagined. You're so surprised. It becomes such a very great object. Now, because of this object, then balan me tada javana me ukkoma, the whole works, right? The whole works. Now, when that whole works appear, balanna minissu hasrena vidhi egulu as udata yanawa moonawal ratu wenawa uda painawa dangalanawa mewa okkoma enne me chittaja rupayan they cannot contain themselves sometimes chittaja rupayan koim kohoma deema chittaja rupayan e uda pana pana these sometimes these people you see on airports well, you know Right, saying goodbye. They're so excited to say meet their people. E velave what happens? The Atimanta Rammana object, and together with that Atimanta Rammana object, the Chittaja Rupas. Right, all of that Chittaja Rupa, that bala. Just imagine that explosion of chittas and energies and rupas together, causing that man or woman to jump up with excitement. That energy has to come from somewhere. That energy comes from that very great object. Right? But then let us imagine you're walking. Let us say you're mindfully walking, and when you're mindfully walking, because you're mindful, you're not getting very excited, right? And you see a person, but because you're so subdued, right? It doesn't, you're not taking it as a very great object, right? Let us say in those moments, it can be a great object, Mahantaram. Right? See? Mahantaram. But the thing is, if sometimes when we are meditating and when you're not identifying, right? And because you're not identifying, you're just taking. Right, and when you're taking that object also, it's quite a blur, right? Because you're not accepting the whole sort of identification in, so it comes and goes, you don't really remember it, right? You don't really remember it because you're not hanging on to something like that. Now at moments of such sort where you're not taking those objects, now those moments where the object is not clear.
But
right.
A slight object.
Sorry?
Very slight object.
When the object, now let us say it's red color. Right? Now, if you see red, that's the object. If you see red, that's the object. Now, let us say you're doing your walking meditation. Right? And let's say that you have a paved walking meditation path. And because it's paved, you don't have to focus, think about anything else, because you know where you're going, you know where you have to go up to, where to turn, all of that. Now, when you're on this meditation path, everything else disappears. Right? Everything beyond the meditation path disappears. Only the meditation with the concrete border or within the concrete border, the sand remains, right? Now, take a moment like that. You did not when your attention was so keenly focused upon the meditation path, the other disappeared. That means you did not take that object at all. Why one-pointedness? The one-pointedness over this moment of sati, you did not see that at all. If you did not see that, that means it was not a great object or a very great object. Like that. So it, if you saw it, then it will fall under one of this.
බන්ති එතකොට එක විෂුවල් සීන් එකක පහමේ හතරම ඉන්න පුළුවන් නේද
එක විෂුවල් සීන් එකක yes
හතරම ඉන්න
yes yes අපි කියමු you're on looking a peacock or something like that right and whilst you're busy sort of adoring the feathers of the peacock the beautiful colors of the feathers you do not see the color of the peacock's beak Let us say. Right. Now, you did not see the color of the beak, right? Because there you did not look at it or you did not note it. Even if you did, you were more taken aback by the feathers and the colors of the feathers. So, if the object did not arise, if the object did not arise, if that was not the way that the object was taken, Okay. Any other questions?
Bante, Teruan Sarnai, is it referring to the objects in the background? Like if you're looking at something, something and focusing on the main object, the objects that are in the background, if you're not focusing on that that much, are those great, great object and slight object? Can we say that these are the objects in the background?
Well, Where do I begin? I was thinking for a moment. Now, let's start here. Objects are not real. There is nothing as an object up until you take that object. When you take that object becomes an object.
Yes. So All if right. we are focusing on that object.
Okay, so let us say right now, if we are looking out at something, right, if we are looking at the computer screens or whatnot, in the background, whatever at that moment, right, is taken as an object, right, within that person, let us say we are when we are talking, we usually look at the teeth, isn't it? When we're talking, we usually look at the teeth. Apparently, subconsciously, it goes to the teeth, right? Regardless. Let's say you're looking at the teeth. Then that is a Mahantarambana or Ati Mahantarambana, right?
Yeah.
But let us say you're not happy. You're not looking for the teeth, no? So let us calm it down and keep it at Mahantarambana, right?
Yeah.
Now... Now, whilst you're looking at the teeth, right, or you're talking to this person whilst looking at the teeth, right, all of this other, the eyebrows, the other parts of this body is there. The moment the eye goes there, that's a viti again. All the rest, now that is the image. It is like same like a camera. Where do you choose to focus? Now, on the phone camera, you can tap on that specific place of the phone and it auto-focuses there. No? Likewise, Padma, because why am I saying so, Pushpa?
Yeah.
Why am I saying so? Because this is a chitta viti.
Yeah.
This is a chitta viti.
The viti, yeah.
It...
Bless you.
Excuse me. This is a chitta viti.
Yeah.
Because it is a chitta viti, the chitta vitis arise according to each respective object that is taken. Right? Now, let us say, Pushpa, whilst we are having this discussion,
yeah.
you hear someone walking on the corridor.
Mm-hmm.
However, you can't be, you're not bothered. You're focused upon what is the lesson, let us say. That
yeah.
sound, you might hear it, but you might not cognize it.
Yeah.
Through the javana, you see. Now, because you did not cognize it through the javana.
Yeah.
Right? Now, when you live in a busy home, you learn to block out these sounds, no? You're very
yeah.
used to it, right?
Yeah.
See, when you're focusing on what you're doing, you might hear that sound, but you're not going to take much note of it, right?
Yeah.
But let us say you're waiting for the bell to ring, the postman to come. Hmm? Or the newspaper to be thrown at your door or something, whatever, right? Now, when you're waiting for such a thing, the moment that you hear the sound, the manodvara may then take it. Oh, is this the postman? Is this the newspaper? Right? But that's a different viti altogether. Right?
Yeah.
That's a different viti altogether.
Yeah.
Okay? So it doesn't depend on meaning. When we look at, if I am, let us say I'm looking at you, at that moment, you're the object. You're not thinking about
yeah.
anything else. Meaning, what I want to reiterate in that, the object, there is nothing as a, how may I say, a self-proclaimed object. An object is whatever you take, you cognize.
Yeah.
That's the object.
Right.
Right. That can become the object of, that can become the object of lust. That can become the object of greed, want. That can be the object of dosa, hatred, envy, avarice. That
yeah.
can be the object of delusion. All of these things that can be the object of restlessness, right? In all these different restlessness doesn't have a proper object. But what I am saying is, in that regard, the fact that that object can be taken with any different sort of mind. Okay, so
yeah.
upon the condition, upon that specific condition, that Atimahantarambhana Mahantarambhana is determined.
All right.
According to that power of object.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you, Bante.
Bante, ekiyanne denne thundene baluwoth ek object ekadiha they might come. Ekiyanne at ekkenekuta atimahanta aramana wenna puluwa ekkenekuta mahanta aramana.
Definitely. Oh, oh, oh.
Oh, ehema wenna puluwa.
Absolutely.
How does it depend, Bante? කොහොමද ඒක ඩිපෙන්ඩ් වෙන්නේ එක එක්කෙනාගේ ප්‍රඥාව විදිහටද නැත්තම්
Now, something that I realized just 2 days ago is me. I've been living at this property for 4 years. I've not realized that there is a support railing to to come in from the garden into the house, right? Now, I did not realize that there was this support railing for 4 years. Right, and the cleaner the other day is pointing this up to me, and I'm wondering what support railing. Right, now this can be absolute carelessness of someone living alone, right? But the thing is, it just doesn't sometimes. An object, you can be an observer, you can be in your mind. Whatever it is, whatever these objects that arise, if it does not drop for you, if it does not sort of, you know,
notice,
catch your, let us say, become a enough condition for you, right?
Yes.
You know, it is like, for example, you might look up and you might see a small sort of discoloration patch. Another person who comes in and takes a look might say, oh, that's mold, or this that's a leak or something else, and you didn't notice because you didn't know.
Oh, I
All
see.
of those things becomes conditions. Right? It is as if, you know, when you learn to sort of what is a red flag and what is a green flag, right? And then sometimes these things don't appear to the mind or don't become objects to the mind there. So it is all then dependent there, again, that condition. This network of condition is so interweaved and complex, weaved over so many different karmic energies formed throughout this samsara, right? It might be difficult to grasp your head around the fact that all of this is the unfolding of karma and karma vipaka, right? Because we are not privy to the wisdom that allows us to see that complex interweaving structure, interwoven structure. But once you realize all of these things, that is why Buddhism, in free, when it comes to free will, as long as you're conditioned, you do not have free will. Because these conditions draw or come and sometimes are established in far deeper places than you would imagine for oneself. The only way to come away from that interwoven sort of complex network is to disengage. How do you disengage? Me dukkha satya, samudaya satya. It's always down to samudaya satya. Samudaya satya. The moment when you think you're in it, you're in it. When you're not in it, you're not in it. Samudaya satya. Or else, again, it goes on being a condition. Now, this Atimahantaraman is going to be a condition for another Atimahantaraman. Another Atimahantaraman. Now, in the Atimahantaraman, as you get excited, you get excited, you get excited. And now the other person is not as excited for you as you are excited for this other person. Now, the Atimahantaraman starts weakening now. And then you grasp onto another object. Atimahantaraman, Mahantaraman, Mahantaraman. Now, that object too. You see, everyone, the great objects, then it dives down, diminishing returns to scale. Again, you find another object. Day by day, we find another object to keep us going, to keep proliferating this moment from one moment to the other. All of that dependent and based upon the hindrances or the anuseya dhammas that keeps proliferating this moment. It's not proliferating samsara. That proliferation of samsara is beginning at this very moment. At this very moment. And in this moment, this is the way that the mechanisms arise and float. According to where you're looking. What is the object you're taking? Do you want to take object? Are you not taking object? Now, just imagine you're in front of the TV, Netflix or whatever it is that you watch, mindlessly, aimlessly gazing at the TV, right? If you take an occasion like that, easy watching, the light on the eyes, light on the head, right? Now you're just gazing out. Now it is not Atimahantaramana, let us say. You're not going on with the story. You're just there, you're just viewing, not even really watching, right? Now, in those moments, those objects, the power of those objects are dependent upon Atimahantaram and Mahantaram, all of this. Right? But the mind can also recollect, no? When the mind recollects those objects, then the mind can take those objects strongly. Huh? Can take those objects strongly. Now, slight object. The object is called slight when it enters the avenue of sense after having passed a few moments and is unable to survive till the arising of javanas. In that case, even the javanas do not arise, but the determining consciousness occurs two or three moments, and then there is subsidence into the life continuum. Into the life continuum. The object is called slight, etc. In the process with a slight object, from four to nine atita bhavangas will pass initially, and no javanas will arise. The determining citta will occur two or three times, after which the cognitive process will subside into the bhavanga. Depending on the number of atita bhavangas, there are six types of process with a slight object. This kind of process is also called vottapanavara, a course ending with determining, manodvare, right? Which is called vottapanavara. So when it ends with the vottapana, it's called vottapanavara. Right? Vottapanavara, very slight object. The object is called very slight when it enters the avenue of sense as it is on the verge of ceasing, and after having passed a few moments, is unable to survive until the arising of the determining consciousness. In that case, there is merely vibration of the life continuum, but no arising of a cognitive process, but no arising of a cognitive process. That is the very slight object. In this course of cognition, there is no process, chittas, but only vibrations of the bhavanga. During the 17 mind moments of the object's lifespan, 10 to 15 moments will be occupied by atita bhavanga chittas, 2 moments by vibrational bhavangas, and the rest by bhavangas subsequent to the vibration. This type of process, of which there are six subtypes, is also termed Moghavara or the futile course, Moghavara. Right? Moghavara, the futile course. The fourfold presentation of objects. Now, let's take a Atimahanta Ramana, great objects. Now, the slight object and the very slight object, where it says that the past bhavanga vibrates, vibrational, and then back to the bhavanga. No process whatsoever in the very slight object. It's only like a hum of disturbance. And then it goes back, just a vibration. Just a vibration. Any questions, anyone? So, now we had a couple of varas that we mentioned. As in the ido, so in the yado, etc. Thus, in all five dos, the fourfold presentation of objects should be understood in due order in the four ways known as, meaning when an object arises, let us say, for example, at the ido, that course, that chittaviti can end with one registration, two javana, three determining or vottapana, or four just by a vibration. Is that clear, everyone? Yeah, so when an object is presented upon the five sense doors, that object can appear, can be, let us say, can be a course which runs its way and ends with a registration. When it ends with the registration, what do you understand? It is Atimahantaramana. when it ends with javana, right? When it ends with javana, what do you understand? What ends with javana?
Mahantaram.
Ah, mahantaramana. Then ending with determining. Ending with determining.
That's paritsanam.
Paritsaramana. And the mogavara, the futile course, atiparintaramana. Sorry. Now, chaitya gattot. If we take a chaitya as an object can be a course ending with registration, ending with javana, ending with vottapana, ending with just a vibration, mogavara. Neither. E thunnama, e hatarama venna pulo. Right? Now, let us see how can a chaitya, a great chaitya, be a determining. Now, you can be chatting to another person next to a chaitya. So, now you're looking at this person. Right? You're looking at this person. You're seeing the chaitya, but you're not taking any notice of it. Right? See? The shift of object can happen, no? Of course.
Right? But if the light is not there, also it can become a mogava.
If a light is not there, yes, it can. Yes, it can. But now, let us say the light is very, very, very slight, right? Let's take a moment like that, where the light is very low.
Mm.
Now, you can barely see, maybe very faint, very faint. It being faint, you can't really grasp nothing almost you can grasp because of the light. All right. Now, any other questions, anyone? Paritaramana, atiparitaramana. Hmm? Kuddhakaramana, atikuddhakaramana. Any questions then? Is it clear? Okay. Then, thus in all five doors, etc., when these four courses are divided by way of their subtypes, there are altogether 15 kinds of sense door cognitive process. Since each of these can occur in all the five sense doors, this make a total of 75 sense door processes. Okay? Altogether, 15 kinds of sense door cognitive processes. 15 teen on Atimahanta Ramanindang?
Very great, ekai, great objects, ekai.
Yeah. Are 15, right? Since each of these can occur in all the five sense doors, 15 into 5, 75. Right? Are
numbers
mono numbers.
නැහැ එක එක පේලියට නම්බරයක් දාලා දැන් බලන්න very very great object එකට එක දාලා ඊට පස්සේ great object එකට දෙකයි තුනයි slight object එකට
දෙක මේ මේවා දෙකක් යන හින්දානේ
ඔව්
බවංග චලන ආස් බවංග දෙකයි යන හින්දා
ඒක හරිද
so they are so quick Dante.
They're so very quick. They're so very quick. And it is because it is so very quick that it is also very difficult for a mundane to see this fallacy. See beyond this as well. Right? Which requires some mental training. So then, summary, there are seven modes and 14 different states of consciousness in the cognitive process. There are seven modes and 14 different states of consciousness in the cognitive process. In detail, they are accordingly 54 in the five doors. Herein, this is the method of cognitive process at the five sense doors. Now we have only done the five sense doors there, right? Is everything clear, everyone?
Then 75 up head there in there.
75.
No.
75? Is 75
15
clear?
into 4 in. Oh, the
15
15
into 5.
times 5.
Oh, 5
15
cents.
into 5. Chakkusota gana jiva kaya 5.
Hi. එතකොට අපි අර කලින් කිව්වේ මනෝ
ඒක තාම
දැන්
අපි සාකච්ඡා කළ නැහැ. මේ කය
කන්න.
ගැන
Okay.
පංචබෝකාර භූමිය විතරයි මේ.
Okay.
හරි. Anyone else?
Bhante අර එතන 14 different states of consciousness කියන්නේ අර අනෙක් chart එකේ තියෙන 14 එක පටන් ගන්න from 4 to 17 නේද? down එකේ. તો ඒකද 14 next approaches of consciousness තියෙන.
No.
එහෙම chart එකක්
Yes. Cool. Mona, what are the 14 then?
ඒක එන්නේ එතකොට five sense do five do adverting it was eye conscious receiving investigation determining ඊපස්සේ javana 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 ඊටපස්සේ registration එනවා දෙකක් it was a stream of bhavanga I think එතකොට
Okay.
එනවා ඔක්කොම අර 17 අර පළවෙනි තුන අඩු වෙනවා
Are
අතීත
14
බවංග
functions, neither?
ඔව් හරි
Hmm?
14 acts of process of consciousness කියන අතීත බවංගයි ඊට පස්සේ vibrational
Yeah.
බවංග එක තරෙස් බවංගය ඒ තුන අඩු වෙනවා ඉතින්
Yeah.
ඒතර 13 තුනක් වෙනකොට අනිත් එක 14යි
Yes, 14.
ඔව්
Those are the 14 functions,
හම්
remember. Functions of consciousnesses. Right.
මේක
So
දාලා
then,
තියෙන chart එකේ දාලා තියෙන 14 acts of process consciousness දැන්
yes.
බන්ති කියන්නේ those are the functions of consciousness
Remember, we studied the functions. The
yes
these states are because the chitta performs that specific function.
function
A function එක තුලත් වෙන දෙයක් නැහැ. Function එකක් විතරයි. A function එක වෙන්නේ එතනට අවශ්‍ය conditions ටික සම්පූර්ණ වුණාම විතරයි. So when, for example, having අර පဋාණි condition එකක් තියෙනවා, when the Dhamma ceases, because the Dhamma ceases, the ceasing of the Dhamma is a condition for the next Dhamma. Meaning, it is only because the previous one ceased that this one arose. Hari, all right. Then,
බන්තේ පොඩි එක ප්‍රශ්නේ ෆන්ක්ෂන්ස් කියන්නේ කිච්චද?
Kitcha.
Thank you.
Kitcha.
Thank you.
And when, let us say, the Manodvara ceases and the Javana rises, for example, when the Manodvara ceasing is a condition for the Javana to arise, taking that position of object. When the object is powerful enough, you see. When the object arose and it was impinged directly right away, Atimahantarambana vu ehetuvin javaneya hatagatta. E mattamana me hetupala dharmaya duwanawa. Huh? Shiroma can't hear.
So the arising of all these chittas can be because the other one ceased.
Yeah.
Then.
Because the previous one sees this arise.
Ceased. Yeah.
Ekat condition nekak.
Hetupalayamai
Hetu pale vitaramai tiyen. Okay. In detail, there are accordingly 54 in the five doors. right, in the five doors. Now, we come to, there are seven modes. What is Mukhadami seven modes? The seven modes in which the process chittas occur are five door adverting, sense consciousness, one of the five, receiving, investigating, determining, javana, registration. The 14 states of the consciousness are obtained by taking the javana 7 and registration twice. The 54 chittas that occur in the five door process comprise all the sense sphere chittas. All the sense sphere chittas. Again, let me do that again. The seven modes. What are the seven modes? Now, this is the seven modes. Five door adverting, sense consciousness, chakku, sota, gana, jiva, any one of them. Receiving, investigating, determining, javana, and registration. Right? Javana and registration. Those are the seven modes. Where do they arise? They arise, those seven modes arise to do what? To take object. The 14 states. The 14 states of consciousness are obtained. This is out of the 17, everyone. Right? Out of those 17, the Javana 7 are obtained by taking the Javana 7 times and registration twice. Right? And registration twice. So, how does the 14 then come all together? All of those functions together with the Javana and the Tadalambana. Right? Javana and the Tadalambana. As one. Because they are one Dhamma there. Right? So, shall we count the 14?
Five-door adverting a parivineka, it passe eye consciousness 2, sampatittana receiving 3, santirana 4 investigation, buttapana determining 5, epata javana tiyena 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and atana hata. It was a tadarama registration dekat tiyena 13, 14.
Okay.
That ekamai seven wenne. Seven
modes. So seven modes ne. Otukota e dharmatavayan modes hatakin pavatinawa.
Modes kiyanne mokada? Modes kiwwama mokada?
When seven modes kiyala kiwwama the way that consciousness or what in what way that consciousness arises. Then javana avasthave chitte hataganne yam kisi vidiyakata.
Javane
ekak kiyala gannawa. Javane ekak. Dan methana modes kiyala gathama ekai. Hari. Otukota anith patta innone 14 states kiyala. 14 states washing gathama states. Every moment after every javana the object changes, no? Hence the consciousness exists in 14 states.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah, 54 chitta kiyani kamavachara citta.
Oh, the 54 chittas that occur in the five-door process comprises all the sense sphere chittas. What are the 54?
Akusal dolahai.
Akusal dolahai. Akusala, akusala, ahetuka,
dahatai.
It's 18, 24 and 12. It's 54. Yeah. So all of those, why are we taking those 54? Because ara chitta vithi thula duna aramunu ganne me wole. Right? But
rupavachara hima wenas.
Itin dhyana avasthawan wala.
Uh-huh.
Dhyana avasthavan vala. ඒ අරමුණු ගන්න ඒ විදියට. හරි.
එතකොට බන්ති එතන ගන්න අපි අර කාමාවචක සෙන්ස්ට්‍රියට් එක විතරයි නේද?
Kamavachar
ඔක්කොම
sensory.
එකයි බියුටිෆුල් එක අර
Because
සියද
it's, why are we taking Kamavachar sensory? Because it's five sense to advert it.
Yeah, five sense to. Dhyana වලට එන්නේ නැහැ නේ සෙන්ස්
වලට.
ඒ ධ්‍යාන කරනකොට භවංග චලන වෙන්නේ නැද්ද?
ධ්‍යාන කරනකොට භවංග චලන බා මේ සෙන්ස් ඩෝ එකෙන් තමයි ධ්‍යාන පටන් ගන්නෙ නේද?
ඒක තමයි. අනේ ෆස් ධ්‍යාන,
ඔව්.
සෙකන්ඩ්, තර්ඩ්, ෆෝර්ත් යනකොට මේ විතක් විචාරුත් නැතිකොට වෙනස් වෙනස් චිත්ත වීතිය ඇති නේද?
ඔතනට පටන් ගන්න අර සෙන්ස් ඩෝ එකින්ම තමයි ඔතනට එතනත් පටන් ගන්න. ඒ ධ්‍යානෙට ගියාට පස්සේ වෙනම කතාවක්.
කතා
රයිට්. ඔතකොට දැන් යම් කිසි විදියකට දැන් කසිනයක් උඩ ධ්‍යානෙකට යනවා නම් හරි ඒ කසිනෙම උඩ first, second, third, fourth ඒ විදියට කසිනු උඩ යනවා නම් ඔතකොට කසිනේ පටන් ගන්නේ යම් කිසි රූපාරම්මණයක්නේ.
object එකක්
රූපාරම්මණයක් උඩ. හරි. Now we come to, now we've done the five and we've done the section of chittavitis pertaining to or that would arise taking a five sense to object. Now what we are going to do is the object or how mental objects are taken. Hari, mental objects are taken.
Bante,
Oh.
Bante, can last time because I was in the car, I put on the thing a little bit later. ගේ සැර කරපු එක 154 පේජ් එකේ අන්තිම පැරග්‍රාෆ් එකේ දෙන following this any one of the 29 sensory javanas කියලා දෙනවා. I couldn't quite understand how we got 29 Bante.
Which one?
On page 154 ගිය වීක් එකේ කරපු එක මම ටිකක්
පරක්කුණා.
ඒකේ අන්තිම පැරග්‍රාෆ් එක following this කියලා තියෙන්නේ අන්නතන ඔය තියෙන අන්න හරි.
Following this, any one of the 29 sensory javanas which has gained the right conditions runs its course, generally for 7 mind moments. After the javanas, two registration resultants arise accordingly. Then comes the subsidence into the life continuum.
The 29 sensory javanas give me a
29 sensory javanas. What are the 29 sensory javanas? 29 javana, javana duwanna puluwang. Kama vachara javana.
Oh.
Othara kiya thiyenoda?
Etana 54 ne.
This is only talking about the javanas. Now, now in the javanas, still you have to take the kama javana kiyuwama akusal 12. Right? I'm just counting off the top of my head. Akusal 12ක් එන්න ඕන. ඔතන කුසල 8ක් එන්න ඕන.
විපාක ක්‍රියා නැහැ.
ඔතකොට විපාක ක්‍රියා ටික නැහැ. මේ රූප වචර කුසල ටික එන්න ඕන, අරූප වචර කුසල ටික එන්න ඕන. හරි, ඔතන 29 තියෙන්න ඕන. I think.
එතකොට 12යි 7යි 8යි කියන්නේ.
5යි 4යි.
එතකොට හේතුක එක
බාන්ට
හේතුක සිතුක් බාදක් දෙනවා නේද ඒකට?
නෑ නේ.
7යි 8යි 15යි 20යි 24යි. තව
It's not normal. කර්ම සිත්තික.
ඒක
වෙන්න ඕන මෙහෙමයි නේද ස්වාමීනි? අකුසල 12, අකුසල 12, කුසල, කුසල and ක්‍රියා 8 plus 8, then hasit uppada
Ah,
vana hasit
sense
uppada
fear javanas. Okay.
sense fear kiyama
Okay. So then akusal, everything that can arise within sense fear, utara kriyat ganna ona. Kriyai hasit uppada. Sorry. Kriya avata kama vachara arumunak ne. Kriya avata kama vachara arumunak.
Javana karanna kriya situlin.
Ayi api dhamma sanganiyatat kare. Dhamma sanganiyata
oh,
when we talk
kriyavati.
about sampayoga, sangyoga. Sangyoga, sangyoga. When we talked about Sangyoga, the objects that are with Sangyoga, Rahatan Vahanse takes objects with Kilesa. Hare? Otukota Rahatan Vahanse Aramuna Kilesa in Gandava Nimi Kiles u Aramuna Gandava. Kiles u Aramuna Gandava.
Ite Kiles Natua.
Ite Kiles Natua. Kiles,
potential.
So 29 javanas, everyone. 12 akusala. Hasatupada 1. Me mahakusala and mahakirya. Ata ata. Okay. 29. Which? Oh. Ekenni kama vachara arunak. Gannuta sense when you're taking that sense object. Right? Only the karma watcher one, sense field.
Oh, it would anusa make a dolhake, no? Rootless a ke are kriatune, no, neither.
Ne,
rootless again,
hasitupada
vitale.
Although the hasitupada chitta arises within an enlightened being, that hasitupada arises upon a sense object. Varnayak, shabdayak, gandayak, rasayak, pottabbayak, uda thama, Rahatan Vahanse namak unath sinnavak pala karanne. Otukota e da api kim metana thiyenne dhatu kiyala. E dhatu tika yam kisi visual ekak arumunak washayen gaththama tamai. Meka arumunak wenne. Arumunak kiyanne hasetuppadata wenne. The enlightened being will not laugh at anatma, at dukkha, at impermanence. He's laughing, or rather he is smiling. Hasidupachitta rises upon some sort of sammuti there. Kama vacharum nakuda. Hare kama vacharum nakuda. A kama vacha arumana enne through the sense field.
It's a good one, and maybe a theory nati question. A kriya sitala anideka in nati.
Munodeka.
Pancadvara sitai manodvara vajana sitai. A deka sense field type in
it. Even on the Javana Valley Hatagan name. However, they are not Javana Chittas. Manodvara Vajana and Panchadvara Vajana, the other two Chittas of the Ahetu Kriya, they have different functions, isn't it? They are not Javana Chittas.
Okay. They are functions. I
mean. They are functions.
Okay.
Yeah, they are functions.
So, Vantit, I'm sorry. My match is getting off. So, the 29, unwholesome again, Dulhak, you know. එතකොට rootless එකෙන් අර මේ හසිත පාද දෙක විතරයි දෙන්නේ එතකොට 13යි එතකොට කොහොමද 29 උනේ
ක්‍රියා 8යි
8 plus
ක්‍රියා 8යි කුසල 8යි
ක්‍රියා 8යි මහා ක්‍රියා 8 මහා කුසල 8
හරි හරි දැන් තේරෙනවා
හරි
එතකොට අපි අතහරින්නේ අර විපාක මහා beautiful එකෙන් අපි attack atarina me vipaka e wage ma rootless ekenut vipaka ekak api atharina habai we have a research of unwholesome
dil if you think in this manner right when
right.
You're looking at the sense sphere right you
yes.
Have the akusala you have the ayetuka and you have the maha sobana right?
Yes.
Oh,
Yes.
now
Oh,
in these three,
yes.
when you think of Javana, what are the chittas within these three sectors, right, which performs kamma, right,
Right.
which performs kamma, which can take an object, which can take an object, right?
Okay.
Now, which can take an object to sort of deduce it. Now, how can you do that? Now, we know the 12 akusala takes object,
Objects, yes.
right? Hence, the
Okay.
12 akusala deduces, and you know, all of the karma is
Yes.
takes.
Hi.
Then let us just skip Ahetuka for now and jump
Yes.
over to the Mahasobhana. We
Yes.
know that Mahasobhana, in the Sobhana Chittas,
Yes.
the mundane beings perform kammas, or they do whatever that they do. The Javana is
Yes,
performed by the Mahakusala Chittas. For
yes.
enlightened beings, they take sense sphere objects through the Mahakriya
Yeah.
Chittas.
Yes.
Right?
Looking at
So both of those, 8 plus 8 there.
the yes, that's
If we then
16
come back to 16, right?
there.
So we have
Oh.
12 from the Akusala now, we have 16 from the Sobhanas now. Right? Now, if you come into the Ahetukas have three categories,
Yes.
right? The Kusala Vipaka, Akusala Vipaka, and the Kriya.
Yeah, yes.
The Kusala Vipaka and the Akusala Vipaka, in this case, they are not Javana Chittas. Why? Because they only support in the taking of object at the sense door. At the sense door. Hence, they don't perceive what the object is. They are not a Javana function. They're only aid in the taking of object at the sense door. Hence, Kusala Vipaka and Akusala Vipaka, Ahetuka Chittas, we disregard. Then we
Right.
are
Okay.
left over with the Kriya
Yes.
Chittas, Manodvara Vajana, Panchadvara Vajana, and Hasetupada.
Yes.
Now,
Yes.
Manodvara Vajana and Panchadvara Vajana, we know now, even having done the Chitta Vithis, these are functions that are supportive of taking object again.
Right.
However, Hasetupada Chitta, it takes object at the Javana level.
Okay, Bante.
Right?
Thank
Hence,
you.
you have 29 sense
Right.
sphere Javanas there,
Yeah.
because they, in them taking object, they are with the object. They are developing kusala or akusala upon the object, or maybe in the case of the arahats, no karma at all, right? But that is done by the Javana Chittas.
Okay.
Okay.
I need to do that. Thank you, Vante.
All right.
Vante, I have a question as well, please. අර පස්සෙම කියපු ක්‍රියා අට 8 plus 8 කියන එක ආවේ සෝබන සිත් වලින්ද, please?
Sobhana, oh.
ඒක විපාක plus ක්‍රියා ආවේනේ අට අට.
Kusala praskriya.
ආ කුසල plus ක්‍රියා.
Yeah.
Okay. ආ
Kusalan kriya.
ඕකේ ආ
Javanani.
සෝබන ආ අනිත් එකෙත් කුසලන්නේ නේද අනිත් ඒවා අනිත් නැන්
ඒවා
12 12 කුසල දුක්
ඔව් හරි
12
අකුසල.
අකුසල අකුසල ඕකේ සෝ අකුසල 12යි කුසල 1යි ක්‍රියා වල කුසල ප්ලස් ක්‍රියා නෑ එක ක්‍රියා
උත්පාදකයි අසිතුප්පාදකයි
පාදේ
ඔව් ඒක තමයි මං කිව්වේ හසිත උත්පාදේක තමයි අරකින්නේ ආ හේතුකෙකින්
ඔව්
හේතුකෙකින් එක Yeah, okay. Thank you.
හරිද
Comes to 29.
29
Thank
honey
you.
now the limited Javana process. When a clear object enters the avenue of the mind o, then the vibration of the life continuum, mind o adverting Javanas, and at the end of the Javanas, registration resultant all take place. Following this, there is subsidence into the life continuum. Following this, their subsidence into the life continuum. Now, what is that? Right? When it comes to, now this is vibhuta. Now let us look at avibhuta. In the case of an obscure object, there is subsidence into the life continuum at the end of the javanas without giving rise to registration. So in the limited javana process, you would have the mindo followed, vibration of the life continuum followed by the mindo, then the javanas, then the tadalambanas, and then into the bhavanga. In the avibhuta ramana, you would have all up until the javanas, no tadalambana. All right, no tadalambana. There should be a chart here. There you go, everyone. Okay, this is the limited javana process. Take a look. The clear object and the obscure. Vibhuta ramana, avibhuta ramana. In the vibhuta ramana, vivid, clear. The bhavanga, right? This is the bhavanga without the object. Now the object appears. Now then we have the vibrational bhavanga, the arresting bhavanga, the manodvara vachana, the seven javanas, two registrations. But in the obscure moment, what happens is, seven javanas run, but it doesn't, the two registrations do not occur. It just goes into the bhavanga, right? It just goes into the bhavanga. Now, will you read this section and come for next time? Okay. With these 163, right? Page number 163. May take up it. Ilang sarayata. Page number 163 to 167 karamu. Up until the absorptions. And then we can follow the absorptions in the following class. හරි මේ ටික හොඳට පාඩම් කරලා ඕගොල්ලෝ රිවිෂන් උත් කරනවා ඒ ටිකත් කරලා මේ ප්‍රශ්න උත්තර එව ලියාගෙන මේ පන්තියට එන්න එපා මේ පැත්තකට වෙලා take part in the class participate in the class hammer dharma like the shepherd you know like the shepherd like in bible study class saying every single day in the father saying I am your shepherd I am your shepherd මටත් වෙලා තියෙන ඔය වැඩේම තමයි දැන් ඒ හින්ද මේ
අපි එකම sheep වලට බැන්දි does that make us all sheep
බෑ කියන්න බැරි එක විතර ඒ හින්ද මේ ප්‍රශ්න ලියාගෙන මේ come with your questions and discuss in the class so that the others get something out of it as well and let's make it a fruitful class last next time as well and the fun times to follow then everyone I will see you on Sunday and I okkomalata therwan sarna yadata
therwan sarna
yadata bye bye take care